Everyone, yesterday you guys took a look at how York County surrendered to the Confederate Army when the Confederates invaded Pennsylvania just before the Battle of Gettysburg in 1863. That's just one part of the story. It wasn't exactly a bright spot for our county's history, but there are some great bright spots that happened in York County, in different parts of York County. So today we're going to take a look at the Battle of Wrightsville. Tomorrow you're going to look at the Battle of Hanover. And in both of those, they had critical importance for the Civil War, but also tremendous importance for the history of our nation and just what happened in trying to help the Union win the Civil War and defend itself against the Confederate advance. So let's get into it here. Now, your objective today is to identify the importance of the defense made in Wrightsville in regards to the overall Union victory in the Civil War. So with what happened in Wrightsville, how did it actually have a bigger effect on the entire Civil War and really on our United States as a whole, on all of the United States history? Now, kind of going back into what you looked at yesterday, what in the world were we going to do to stop the big, bad Confederate Army? They've got 75,000 men that are coming up from Virginia. What you can hopefully see here is that the Confederates came up and they made it into Pennsylvania. The Union had no idea what was happening. The Confederates are moving quickly, and they also shaded themselves by the mountains, and so the Union couldn't even see their movements. They got up, they invaded the area of Carlisle, the area of Chambersburg. They took over Gettysburg for a little bit, and they also took over York on June 28th of 1863. But they invaded South Central Pennsylvania. They took over York County. There was hardly any Union presence whatsoever in Pennsylvania, and all we had here were just over 1,000 militia. But we knew what they wanted. What they wanted altogether was, I'll come back to some of this stuff here. What they wanted was Harrisburg. They wanted that city of Harrisburg because Harrisburg was the biggest railroad junction in the entire state of Pennsylvania, one of the biggest railroad junctions in the entire nation. If they could cut off that railroad junction at Harrisburg, they could split this railroad line that carried all the goods coming from New York and New Jersey and around eastern Pennsylvania, and then that rail line would go down into Maryland, down towards West Virginia. But all of these critical supplies that the Union needed, as well as the movement of troops, that rail line would be cut off and it would significantly hinder the ability for the Union to fight the Civil War. So the Confederates desperately, desperately wanted to take Harrisburg. That's their big goal. They didn't really care about York. York was nice, but they knew that York had a bridge which they could use to cross over into Lancaster County and then eventually get up to Harrisburg. So York was okay. York could provide them with some materials. That wasn't the big goal. The big goal was Harrisburg. So that city was their overall destination of choice that the Confederates wanted. It was not Gettysburg. It was not York. It was Harrisburg. Now, to come back into this story, June 28th of 1863, the Confederates take down the United States flag from right in the center of our town at Center Square. So right between George Street and Market Street, they take down that flag and they put up the Confederate flag. And John Gordon gives a speech. And in that speech, he tries to say, hey, you don't need to worry about us. We're not going to burn down your town. We're not going to hurt anybody. You're safe with us here. And a little girl, a 12-year-old girl, comes up to him with a bouquet of roses. And in the roses is a note. Weirdly, it shows him exactly how to attack the small Union force, the militia, the guys that are kind of just like Minutemen-style troops back in this time here. The note shows him exactly how to attack our Union troops in York County and how to surprise them. John Gordon doesn't know if he should actually believe it at first, but eventually he realizes, like, this looks pretty legit. And so he takes a portion of his army, and he moves out to Wrightsville, where these guys are heading, where the Union troops are, and he makes this attack. The crazy thing is, the note is actually handed to him by a member of the Small family. Now, that might not have much importance to you, but the Small family is the family that actually created York College, created York Hospital, created the Children's Home of York. They had done so much for York County, it's ridiculous. They're also a huge business-owning family in York. So the fact that they're actually supporting the Confederate cause is pretty questionable here. There were some members of the Smalls that were Northern, that were pro-Northern, and obviously some that were pro-Southern. And so it's pretty split family here, but a very, very important family back in this time period in 1863. And they look like they are, at least a part of the family is pro-Southern. So let's move on here. You have these 1,800 men under John Gordon that are going to move out to Wrightsville. John Gordon leaves Jubal Early, his second in command, another Confederate general, to take over the operations in York City to try to get as much money out of York as possible. They requested $100,000 and all sorts of goods, from coffee to flour to baked bread to beef, all sorts of things. And so York gave them what they could, but Jubal Early was in charge of taking as many things as he could from York as possible. John Gordon's going to move on. He's going to go towards Wrightsville, and he's going to try to take the only bridge that York had across the Susquehanna River, so that eventually the Confederates could go across that bridge and then move up towards Harrisburg. Head up here, go take that big railroad junction that the Union had of Harrisburg. But go get this bridge, cross that bridge, and go take that big city that was their primary destination in this entire invasion of the North. Let's get down to it here. Reason why the Confederates wanted to cross that bridge is that the Union had good defenses west of Harrisburg, but nothing to the east. So if they can cross the bridge, they'll take Harrisburg easily. The Union force, just over 1,000 men, move back, some of them being York County men, move back towards Wrightsville. They realize they're pretty weak, so they started digging in and entrenching as quickly as they possibly could. So they got their shovels to work and tried to create the best defenses they could. Some railroad men from the Reading Railroad actually started to take some dynamite. They spoke with the commanding officer out there around Wrightsville, this militia group, and they said, should we try to get this bridge set up so it can be ignited if need be? And the commanding officer said, absolutely. And so they started placing dynamite in different spans of the bridge as a just-in-case measure so that they blow up the bridge if they have to. Well, shortly after the attack came, the Union forces could only hold out for a couple of hours before the Confederates were going to overrun them. So the word came back from the commanding officer, go ahead, light the bridge. So they ignited it. They blew up different spans of the bridge. The Union troops started to retreat first before they decided to light the whole thing on, like to ignite it. But the Union troops got away. Multiple spans of the bridge blasted away into the river. The bridge was impassable. And now the Confederates were stuck on the York County side of the Susquehanna River, and they were never going to be able to get across this bridge. So the Union actually destroyed the bridge themselves, and the Confederates could not get across. Kind of nice, actually. The Confederates actually put out some of the fires, but so many spans, so many parts of the bridge were already so destroyed that the Confederates could not come across. And altogether, that's really the end of the story, because on the next day, Robert E. Lee of the Confederate Army, he realized that the Union was on the move, and they're getting up towards Pennsylvania as fast as they possibly could, so they did not have time to waste. And the Confederates were so split, dangerously split. They had troops in Chambersburg, they had troops in Carlisle, they had troops around the western side of Harrisburg, even though they never actually took the city of Harrisburg. They had troops in York, but the Confederates had troops here, 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 and here. And anytime the enemy army is getting close, you don't want to be split up. You want your troops to be concentrated. So Robert E. Lee, that big guy of the Confederate Army in the Civil War, said, we need to concentrate as fast as possible around this town here of Gettysburg. And so the next day, on June 29th of 1863, the Confederate Army started to move back, move out, and leave York County and head towards a place where they can concentrate with the rest of the entire army. And that's how they ended up in the Battle of Gettysburg. They didn't really plan it. They didn't really expect to fight a battle at Gettysburg. They just expected to fight a battle someplace around Pennsylvania or Northern Maryland, and it just so happened that it occurred at Gettysburg. But regardless here, what these troops did, what these Union troops did at Wrightsville, even though they didn't hold out for that long, and what the Reading Railroad men did by blasting portions of that Wrightsville Bridge, Wrightsville-Columbia Bridge, saved the Union in that nick-of-the-time effort. It was able to allow Harrisburg to be saved and for the Confederates to not be able to pull off their primary objective in this entire advance into Pennsylvania. Now, last thing here that I want to share, or last couple things. Wrightsville, still, about every 5 years, they throw a big celebration where they do a reenactment of the burning of the Wrightsville-Columbia Bridge. And so look for that sometime. The date of it was June 28th. And so look around June every single year. There's going to be some publications out to see when the next one is, but you can see the people all get together and have a nice picnic, have a nice night. They have music, concerts, they have all sorts of stands. So a wonderful thing, but check it out when it ever comes around. And lastly, if you want to dig into this further, the leading Civil War scholar in York County, this is the guy you see on the right, his name is Scott Mingus. He goes around and speaks all over the area. I've listened to a couple of his speeches, and he also has this video that's located on YouTube if you want to dig even deeper into what happened here in the Battle of Wrightsville, deeper than what I've covered with this. And so, tremendous, tremendous resource, but this guy is the point person in York County for Civil War history. All right. Thank you. Till next time.